What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Aisha and I do fashion hauls and lifestyle related videos. If you guys are into that kind of stuff, please hit the subscribe button as well as the notification bell so that you know when I post new videos. Also, I'm gonna leave my Instagram over here and you can feel free to check it out. I feel like this video is so delayed, and I think it is because of how extensive the try-on portion was, but today I am going to be sharing with you guys my entire winter coat collection. I just wanted to say that I've actually accumulated these coats for the past couple of years now, and I've purchased them year to year, so that may mean that some of them may not be available online anymore, but I am super excited to show you guys, so let's get into it. Alright, let's start out with this coat. This coat is the Jacqueby coat, and I feel like it is the most appropriate coat to start out with because this is the first ever coat I actually purchased from Aritzia. I think it's definitely safe to say that this coat really ignited my love for Aritzia coats, and this is where it all started. Every time winter rolls around, I am so thankful that I purchased this coat because I wear it every season. It isn't the thickest of coats. I do have thicker coats than this, but I really do love the fit and the style that it offers. I save this coat for the days that aren't as chilly, where I don't need my puffer, and whenever I wear it, if it's too cold, I do end up layering underneath it, just like I talked about in my how to stay warm in winter video. But let me show you guys how I style this coat. Okay, the next coat I have is actually my one camel coat that I own, and it is the Hewitt coat from Aritzia. I purchased this coat, I want to say about 3-ish years ago, but I don't really gravitate towards it anymore, and I think it may be because of the color. When I purchased this piece, the camel color was really on trend, and it is a beautiful color, no doubt about that, but sometimes I feel that it clashes with my skin tone, and unlike a black or gray coat, when I have to wear this or when I want to wear this, I feel like I have to really think about the different ways I'm going to style this piece. I do absolutely love it though. It's one of the reasons I haven't donated it or sold it yet, because it is a really nice piece. I love the A-line fit it has, but if I were to go back and purchase this coat again, I would definitely purchase it in a longer length or just find something that is a little bit longer, because that is more of my style now. I guess when I was purchasing it back then, I didn't really notice. All I wanted was a camel coat, but if I were to go back, definitely would purchase this in a longer length. It is also very similar to my Stedman coat from Aritzia, which I will actually show you guys next, but for now, let me try this on for you guys. Okay, the next coat is the Stedman coat, and this is by far 100% a staple in my winter wardrobe coat collection, I guess. I purchased this coat a really long time ago, and I have worn it countless amount of times, and I love, absolutely love the timeless look it has to it. I think Aritzia also noticed how much their customers were loving this coat, I think, because since I have purchased it every single year, they re-release it with a different fabric or a different color. When I initially purchased it, the color was very limited. There was a dark charcoal gray, there was this gray, and I think there was a black. Now they have literally pink in this coat. Like, they have so many different colors that come in this coat, and it really is just a staple. I think the gray is just such a safe choice because it pairs with absolutely everything. The fit is A-line, just like the Hewitt, and though I wish it was a little bit longer, I do just love the overall style for it, and I'm gonna try it on for you guys now. Alright, the next coat isn't an Aritzia one. I thought I'd give my Aritzia coats a break for a little bit. It's actually an H&M piece that I purchased, I want to say, 2-ish months ago. This coat was such an incredible find for me. Oh look, the price tag is still on. Well, not the price tag, it's just a tag. But yeah, I don't like taking tags off of my clothing. I don't know why. I just do it after the longest time, so the price tag is still on. But anyways, this coat I purchased from H&M, and it was such an amazing find for me because I was randomly going through H&M's website and I found this coat and I think it was listed for $50 to $60, which was such an incredible steal. Before purchasing this coat, I actually didn't have one that was in this style specific, and I'm so glad that I purchased it because first of all, I love the collar that it has. I just feel like when I button it all up, the collar looks really, really nice. And I also just really love the big buttons. It has big buttons all throughout its length, and it also has big buttons on its sleeve. I just feel like it adds so much character to the coat, and it's just really nice. I want to say that this is really different from my go-to style. Before I purchased this, I would just go for coats that were more like A-line or more flowy. This one is a very oversized, I want to say bulky look, but what drew me to it was the herringbone pattern that it actually had. It's such a long and warm piece, and even though it is oversized, I just like the style that it gives me, but let me try it on for you guys. Okay, sticking with H&M, the next coat I have is another piece from there. So this black coat is actually a little bit special because I purchased this piece when I was in Paris on my honeymoon. For my honeymoon, I packed outfits thinking that it would be really warm, but in fact, it was actually really cold. I don't know what was up with the temperatures in mid-August. It was just freezing. We were roaming Paris and I was wearing a dress, and honestly, that day was so cold that I didn't know if I was gonna make it through the day without like going back to the hotel and layering something on or just buying a piece. So we ended up finding the closest H&M near us, and I went in and purchased this coat. This coat does have more of a menswear fall, which I guess I clearly like because I have the Hewitt and the Stedman, which offer the same look as well. This coat in specific, I find to be a great transitional piece from the fall to the winter or from the winter to the spring, just when the temperatures are about to get cool, not cold because it isn't thick. So when the temperatures are cool, I definitely take this piece out and I start wearing it. Okay, I think we're almost done. I think I have like three more coats to show you guys, but moving on to this coat. This is a coat from Zara, and it's a robe style coat, and I just really, really love the color of it. This coat is probably the biggest coat I have in my closet. It is so long and it is so oversized at the same time. It just feels like you're wearing a big blanket when you put it on. I really like the details it has along the neck, and I love the gigantic pockets it has. I can literally put my camera in here with its like little tripod stand, and it conceals perfectly. Like the pockets fill so many things in that it is so useful. Overall, it's just a really amazing piece, and I love styling it in the winter and fall times. This piece in specific is one that works great as a transitional piece. I can wear it on the cold days as well because it has so much space underneath it that I can layer whatever I want underneath. But also when it isn't as cold, I can wear it standalone and it still gives me the warmth that I need for the cold temperatures. I really do love this piece, and I'm so happy that I purchased it last year because I have definitely worn it a numerous amount of times. But let me show you guys me trying it on. Okay, the next coat is actually this beautiful blue piece from Topshop. I purchased this coat when I was working at Topshop, and it is such a long coat. This coat hits, I want to say, right below my knees. Again, it is an A-line fit with more of a loose menswear look, and it's just really nice. It has two buttons right over here for closure and two big pockets right over here. I love wearing this piece in the fall time specifically. In the winter time, I don't really gravitate towards it too much because it is really thin. Even if I layer underneath it, it is just too thin to keep me warm because I am just overall a cold person, but I do like wearing this in the fall time or in the springtime when the weather it gets down to a nicer temperature. I love pairing this with trousers and with jeans. It's such a casual coat that it literally goes with everything, and no matter how I style it, I always just end up loving the look that it gives. Let me show you guys how this looks on, and then we will move on to our last coat. Thank you. All right, so the last one isn't really a coat because, I don't know, just it's not a coat, but I wear it as a coat. It is my long luxe cardigan from Babaton. I know I've talked about this on my channel before. I think it was actually in my January 2020 favorites video. I know I've mentioned it a couple of times on this channel, but honestly, this cardigan is, again, it gives me the style that the Zara robe coat had. It is such a long cardigan with the biggest pockets ever, and it's super, super warm. It has a really nice thick lining, which keeps me warm. The one thing that I will say that I wish it didn't have are these slits right over here. Like, I know why they have it is because it's not a coat, it's a cardigan, but if it didn't have those like slits at the side, I would be so warm in this and I wouldn't really have a problem with wearing it outside by itself. I find that the lapel collar it has is also great. Sometimes I wear it up like this and I just feel extra chic when I wear it like this because, I don't know, I just feel like I'm more important than I actually am when I wear my collars up. It just adds to the style that it already has and it elevates my look like times 100. Overall, it is an amazing piece and let me try it on for you guys and then we will be done. Okay, and those were all of my winter coats with the exception of some fall coats. Again, I've accumulated these coats over the past several years and I feel like I have a pretty good baseline of my like foundational coats. Now what I need is I need coats with patterns on it. I realized this when I was looking in my closet is that I don't actually own a lot of coats that have patterns. So next I'm gonna be looking into investing in pieces that are like plaid coats or herringbone patterns. I just want more of a variety within my coat collection. I've said this before, but I'll say it again. I just feel like when you live in colder climates, coats are really the only way that you can really truly express your style. Over here, we have approximately 8 to 9 months of winter and then we get summer for 3 months, but the majority of the year we spend in cold climates. And I feel like if I didn't give any importance to coats, I would really have a hard time styling items because I really rely on these coats to help me style, honestly, my entire outfit. I find that I can really just throw anything on underneath and if I put a nice coat on top with some boots and a nice hat, my outfit instantly looks better than it did before. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I know some of you have said that you wanted to see what was on my rack that is behind me when I film like the try on portion, and this is pretty much it, give or take like two coats that are more for my spring collection, but this was what's on my wardrobe. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and again, if you have any videos that you would like to see, please do let me know. I love reading your suggestions and I love implementing them into videos that I can make, so let me know if there's anything you guys want to see. But on that note, thank you so, so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!